Hello, my name is Jessica. I am a student nurse at Morrisville State College. I am here practicing today for a complex dressing change. For this patient over here, he has an abdomen wound, and we're doing a complex dressing change of moist to dry. I am combining all my dressing changes in order to change the wound dressing from with normal saline from moist to dry with the patient over here. And I have to collect everything I need before I go see the patient. I have surgical sterile gloves, the sponges that I'm going to be packing it with in the wound, the normal saline that will keep the wound moist, and then I need the sterile cotton swabs to press the wound packaging in, a combined pad that goes over everything, and the tape that will keep it down. I also need to add 3 pairs of clean gloves. Add it to my bag, and then I need to get the paperwork in order to see what my orders are for the wound change. So once I have my orders, and I know where I need to go, which will be this person right here, which is number 1. I need to hand sanitize every single time before I see a patient. And the patient has the right to ask if I did hand sanitize before I come in. And I introduce myself. Hello, my name is Jessica. I am the student nurse. I go over and I check his ID band. Afterwards, I check his safety. The brakes are on, so the bed's not moving. He is on the lowest position possible. He was, now he is. Safety. And I check to see if he has the call bell, which for us is this. He just presses it if in case he needs any help. So he always needs it within his hand range. After that, I explain what I'm going to do with the patient. Today I will be doing a wound dressing change from moist to dry. I need the patient flat because it is on his abdomen. And then I organize my stuff that I'm going to be using. Now I don't need to use 2 until the end of the procedure, so I just set those aside. I will be using 2 clean gloves in the beginning of my procedure. I need the trash bag because I'll be throwing all the stuff I will be doing for the wound change right into the trash bag. And we always put it at the end of the bed. We need a ruler, the combine pad that we need, 2 of the sterile cotton tips we'll be using, 2 gauze sponges. One will be dipped into normal saline and the other one will be dry. We need another gauze tip pad because we'll need it to measure the depth of the wound. We also need sterile surgical gloves because when we do that, this will be the procedure for the sterile gloves. This is the clean procedure. Don't need tape yet, but that also involves the clean gloves at the end of the procedure. Sterile always needs to be above the waist. Everything above the waist is sterile. Anything below the waist is unclean and has to be thrown away. In order for me to not break my back, I usually have the patient go up. So I put the guardrail down. I can do that if I am by the patient's side. If I leave the patient's side, the bed has to be down and the guardrail has to be up. Mr. Maxwell, I'll be bringing down your blanket and revealing your abdomen. This is what we'll be changing right here. In order for me to start changing, I need to take off the old one. So I put on my clean gloves, the first of many. Once those are on, I take off the wound. I usually start at the ends, at all 4 corners, because somehow I think opening the ends doesn't hurt as much. And then I gently take it off, and then normally I would check to see if there is any wound drainage, and if there's any discolorations, and then I'd have to throw it out. Then I check the other gauzes that are on top, see if there's any infections or bacteria that are growing. So you have to check every single one, even the ones that are packed in. And last one. We're going to pack it with 3, just the same as the last one. All right, so we check to see the color of the wound. Right now it has a pink granulation tissue, so that means it is healing. If there was any wound drainage, like serous, which is clear, or serosanguinous, that's clear and bloody, and sanguinous is bloody. But if we see any other discolorations, like green, black, or anything, we'd have to let the doctor know and see if we can help with that. So after taking all that off, I have to take off my clean gloves and throw it out. Next, I'll have to put on another new pair of clean gloves because we'll be measuring it. We have to measure it to see if it is closing from the last time it was measured. because it's a secondary intention wound, which means it's closing from the inside out. It's not stapled and it's not needled or anything like that. So it's healing by being open. So we take our ruler, we measure the longest length for the wound, which for this one would be 14 centimeters long. We'd also measure the longest width that we can see, which for this one would be 2.5 centimeters width. Next, I'll have to open up my little cotton tips. They're sterile, so if they touch the table for even a second, that means they're unclean. So I just take one, because that's all I need. And then I put it into the wound as deep as I can go without causing the patient pain. And I have to measure how deep the wound is. And then I measure it against the centimeters, because we can't measure it within inside, and it's 2.5 centimeters. Now we have to take off our gloves, the clean ones. And now we're going to sterile field. We'll be opening all the sterile fields, as I said before. If we open these and they touch anything outside of their barrier, which includes the outside barrier here, that means they're dirty, unclean, you have to throw it out. So everything has to stay within their barriers. I cannot even put my hand above it because that also makes it unclean. So we make sure it's enough. Now we're gonna open the dry gauze. Now we also gotta open the cotton tips. And I'm opening the sterile gloves. These ones are a little bit special because we can open this and we can touch this. This is still clean. But in order for me to open this entirely, I'm gonna open it on the side because it takes up a lot of space. And this is where the most space is. You can see, I'm still not touching the gloves. And you can see right here, right and left. So it actually tells you which hand you have to put it on. Then you still don't touch on the inside because that's also sterile. And you open it like this. Now, all steriles have a 1-inch border. So immediately, the 1-inch border, unclean. Then I have to grab this from the outside right here, because the inside of the glove is clean. Outside is sterile. In order to get the next glove, I have to put it where the sterile is. Because that makes the outside still sterile and I can still touch the other stuff. Now I'm done with this. I can throw it out. And then I have to clasp my gloves and turn the table with my feet in order for me to touch this. Now we let the patient know that we are going to pack the wound. We would use the moist cloths. You take it and you squeeze it so we don't have too much moistness. Too much creates bacteria. And we twirl it. And then we pack the wound. We can't touch skin because then it'll create an unsterile field. We can touch it, but it is easier to use the cotton swabs to put it down. But same with the other rules, we can't touch the skin when we're packing it. And then we do another one. So we pack it, make sure this is within the skin and the wound. We would like for it to be packed within the wound. Now we can push down with our fingers, but our fingers cannot touch skin. That means it's unsterile. Pretty much our entire process. Make sure it's not too much above the skin. There we go. Okay, next we take 3 dry dressings and put them above the wound. So if there's any more leakage or anything that we need to be wary of, it'll catch it. And last but not least, we need the pad. This is the inside of the pad. The outside, you can see where the line is, so we know which one it is. And we put it right above the wound and the wound packagings and everything like that. Now that the sterile field is now all set, we don't need the sterile gloves anymore. Because once that pad is on top, it becomes clean because it's touching air. So we throw away our sterile gloves, throw away our entire field. All sterile is unclosed underneath the pad and we do not need sterile anymore. We turn to clean because we need to tape it down so if the patient moves, he won't have the wound packaging going flying. And we don't need that. So we go to clean, put on some gloves, and we get taping for the wound. I always kind of try to measure it out because we don't want a lot of tape, because if we have a lot of tape, it might cause pain when we're taking it off. Ask the patient if there was any pain throughout the entire process. The patient states no, that's good. But since we are all set, we'd bring the gown down, cover him up. We always want to create privacy. Make sure he or she has the call belt. And bring the patient all the way down. Because if the patient's too high up, they could get out of bed and fall. And that's a fall risk. And create more injuries, and the hospital would have to pay, not him. You always at least want to bring your patient up for at least 30 degrees for better inhalation and exhalation for lungs. After you're done with that, still got the trash within the room. So you would take it all out. All done with that, so you can get rid of your gloves. The last of them. And in order for us to get rid of it, we can't just go down and let the air out because that creates contamination. So we just twirl it right here and tie. I usually tie it twice because just how I was taught. Okay, brakes are on, patient's all the way on the lowest feature for the bed and call bell. And then you ask if the patient needs anything else. If he does not, just let him know that he can ring the call bell and we'll be right on over. We move the curtain away because, of course, patients want to see the outside world. Grab the trash bag, throw it out, and of course, the most important step, always hand sanitize before you leave a patient's room. And that's it. The end.